We start with that breaking news from the US first. And OJ Simpson, the celebrity murder suspect acquitted in what was dubbed the trial of the century, has died. The former football star turned Hollywood actor was 76 years old. Let's go live to US correspondent Tim Lester. Tim, OJ's death closing a very controversial chapter in American legal history.
Yes, Eddie, good morning. A remarkable rise to stardom from OJ Simpson so many years ago, but then an absolutely bewildering fall to the status of villain in the United States. Across the US today, and perhaps especially here in California, where so much of his story unfolded, they're considering the meaning of OJ Simpson's life.
He was an American hero on so many levels. OJ Simpson, football legend, inducted into the Hall of Fame after retiring, Hollywood called.
Nobody does it better.
TV and movies.
Norbert!
Hiya, buddy. Hey! Doc says I should be on my bean and as good as new in a week.
In 1985, he married Nicole Brown. The glamorous couple had two children, divorcing 7 years later following allegations of domestic violence. In 1994, Nicole Brown and her friend Ron Goldman were found dead at her Los Angeles home.
They may be driving a white or light-coloured Ford Bronco.
Simpson was charged with their murders, but failed to turn himself in and was declared a fugitive, leading police on a low-speed two-hour chase across LA before eventually surrendering, watched live by 95 million people. The trial of the century followed, televised and captivating America. Crucial evidence, blood-stained gloves found at the scene. In one of the trial's most memorable moments, prosecutors asked Simpson to wear the gloves. He struggled to put them on, the blunder leading to a now famous closing statement from Simpson's lawyer.
If it doesn't fit, you must acquit.
It took the jury just 4 hours to reach a verdict.
We, the jury, in the above entitled action, find the defendant, Orenthal James Simpson, not guilty.
3 years later, OJ was found liable for Nicole and Ron's deaths in a civil suit brought by the victims' families. A dramatic fall from grace. OJ was back in court multiple times over the next several years for traffic violations, even pirating cable TV. But it was a Las Vegas robbery in 2008 that ultimately sent him to prison. He served 9 years before being released in 2017. In a statement, Simpson's family revealed that he died of cancer, surrounded by his children and grandchildren. OJ Simpson was 76.
For those not around in the mid-1990s, it's worth knowing that Time magazine at the time described his court case as the Godzilla of tabloid stories. It really was something. And as Americans look back on his life today, they're likely to say, wow, that was a wild ride. Eddie.
It's an incredible story, isn't it, Tim? We'll reflect more and look back during sunrise. We'll see you then. Police have stepped up the search for missing Ballarat mother Samantha Murphy, calling in specially trained sniffer dogs from New South Wales for the first time. They won't reveal what it is, but fresh information has steered the hunt to a new area of bushland 25 kilometres south of Ballarat. The animals and their handlers hunted in the scrub for any trace of the mother of three as they compile their case against Patrick Stevenson, the 22-year-old charged with murder. Samantha's husband, Mick Murphy, left disappointed after police efforts returned no results, and that search will resume today. Samantha Murphy was the first of three local women to be killed this year, her death followed by Rebecca Young and last week Hannah Maguire. The three deaths had prompted the Ballarat community to hold a rally scheduled for this afternoon, demanding an end to violence against women.
This is happening far too often. Women must have the right to live safely, to live freely, to live without fear.
Samantha Murphy's husband, Mick, is expected to attend that rally today. Sydney's rental market has hit a new crisis point with prices at record highs as vacancies dip to their lowest level ever. New South Wales Premier Chris Minns has declared the situation to be untenable and that the future of the city is now at stake with the rental crisis ongoing.
The situation at the moment for renters in Sydney, one of the most expensive cities in the world, is completely intolerable.
The government is being called to invest in social and affordable housing with 60,000 people now still on the waiting list. Police have charged a second man over the killing of Melbourne underworld figure Gavin Capable Preston. A seven-month manhunt for the killer led detectives all the way to the Sydney CBD where the arrest took place. It's understood surveillance teams had been following the 24-year-old man for some time before he was arrested. He has been accused of gunning down the gangland figure last September in Keilor. He'll be extradited to Victoria and taken into custody with his alleged 23-year-old accomplice. A man remains in hospital this morning after trying to stop a robbery in Sydney South. The 23-year-old staff member was working at a servo in Kingsgrove when he noticed a man trying to steal from the fridge. He chased after him, suffering multiple stab wounds during the scuffle. The worker astoundingly returned to work for another 30 minutes before then calling for help, with an ambulance taking him to hospital in a stable condition. Police are hunting for his attacker this morning. Social media platform Instagram has announced it's deploying new tools to protect kids and combat sexual extortion, including a feature that will automatically blur nudity in direct messages. Now anyone trying to forward a nude image will receive a message encouraging them to reconsider. Only this week, two Nigerian men were arrested over the alleged sex torture of a 16-year-old Australian boy who then took his own life last year. A new study has claimed that 70% of Australians who use drugs obtained their substances from online messaging platforms. Experts are calling for services like WhatsApp, which is owned by Mark Zuckerberg's Meta, to help police catch criminals dealing cocaine, ice and other harder drugs. A professor from Melbourne's RMIT University says politicians should closely follow a US investigation into whether Meta is facilitating and then profiting from the sale of illicit substances. It's something a bit different. Calling all chocolate lovers, today is the day fan favourite sweets Polly Waffles will hit shelves again. For the first time in 15 years, the chocolate's filled with wafer and marshmallow were discontinued by Nestle in 2009. Has it been that long? Before being purchased and reimagined into Polly Waffle Bites by South Australian confectioner Roburn Menz. The sweet treats will be rolled out today, starting at supermarkets across the country. Checking Friday's weather for you now, possible afternoon shower in Brisbane at 27, mostly sunny in Sydney in 24, partly cloudy in Canberra and 21, a shower or two in Melbourne at 18, partly cloudy in Hobart and 19, partly cloudy in Adelaide 21 degrees, mostly sunny in Perth 29 and partly cloudy in Darwin and 33 degrees.